Hello everyone! If you program long enough, eventually you will run into a programming art category called obfuscated code. They receive a recurring international contest where the point is to create as impressive programs as possible in a relatively small number of C source code characters. For a beginner programmer, it may seem unfathomable how such clever and OPQ designs could come to be. In my long-running series called Don't Do This, let's go over some basic techniques that people who write obfuscated code use to write obfuscated code. For the point of this exercise, let's create a simple Hello World program. This Hello World program looks at the current local time of day and offers an appropriate greeting for that hour. First, we begin by reducing redundancy. We can use a variable to differentiate the different printfs, so we will only need one. Now it would be much neater if we could collect all these different greetings into a single array and use that array. The switch case can be converted into a table. For each hour, one of the greetings is selected, and the table maps the hour into a greeting index. Now we can delete the whole switch case. This may remind you of what I did in the NES emulator. It is pretty much the same thing so far. Variables can be initialized in the same statement they are declared. Let's do that. This is no-brainer to C++ programmers, but C is more picky of the situations where you can do that. Variables that are only assigned and read once can be inlined. There is no need for the variable. Note that this runs very much opposite to good development principles, but when you are creating obfuscated code, good development principles are pretty much defenestrated. Character arrays often require significantly smaller estate in the source code than integer arrays do, even though some additional mathematics is necessary to convert the characters back into numbers. In C, it is not necessary to declare all functions before their use. If the function is not declared, the compiler guesses the prototype when the function is called. For print, this guess turns out to be good enough. When stdio is removed, there will be warnings when the program is compiled, but it still works. The time header cannot be removed because there are structure types and type aliases declared there that the compiler cannot guess. We can also make some other changes that decrease the pedantic correctness of the program, such as changing null into zero, removing the void and const keywords. Now, a single string constant is much shorter than 5 of them, let alone 7 of them. Let's concatenate them all. After all, strings are nothing but character arrays, and we can still access any particular substring we want by crafting a custom character pointer. Here, this custom character pointer is made from the string pointer and an index into the same string. The index is written as a character whose ordinal value translates into the offset. The final remaining step is to remove most of the white space, and the artistic creation is complete. There are many other techniques that I didn't cover in this video, and every creator devises new ones, but hopefully this gave some insight on this particular direction of artistic programming style that the C language enables. I am Joel. Thank you for watching. Until next time, bye!